Okay, so basically, I'm a marketer and I do online marketing and I teach people how to use LinkedIn and I do product launches as well. And that's all. Actually, my journey started with I did a job as an HR earlier, like 2013, 14, 15, yes. So I started my career with a job of HR and then I left HR. Then internet industry got my attention that I should start something like my own, and because I was working with the company which was dealing in digital marketing itself, so I always had a dream to start something my own and with a working, getting my laptop outside and then start something on that. So that by then in 2016, 15, and it got my attention. The laptop style, laptop lifestyle. And then I started learning about digital marketing. And you can say that 2016, early January, February, I started my career in digital marketing.
The last 4 years in your entrepreneur journey, what was your learnings, like how they should start or how they should proceed in the digital marketing or the copywriting?
All right. So first of all, in digital marketing, when somebody is entering now these days, as a lot of people, they have already entered in this digital era, right? And we feel like this is very competitive now because companies, they are not actually hiring freshers who are actually starting their career. It is now very competitive. But how I started, there is like one twist, or maybe you can say one of the magical things which I did when I started. I never learned from any institute. That's the, I like very few people, they have PhD.
Okay.
I guess very few people, they are aware of it. So how I started, I actually started with the taking projects. I left my job. I was working with an HR, so I left my job and then I took like little bit basic of training with the help of Gaurav. You are aware of it, who is Gaurav Madan, right?
Yes.
So I started learning from him. So he taught me some of the basic thing and then I started applying for the job. So I went to one of the company there and I took that job and it was all on the basis of my basic experience only, basic knowledge only. And I was quite confident enough to take the project because I really wanted to do the job just for my learning purpose, not for the money. So obviously, it was for money, but my primary, expectation was to learn. And that time when I started journey, I had not enough money that time. So, but as you know, in digital marketing, when you're entering into, you have to have a practical knowledge.
Exactly.
And for the practical knowledge, you have to spend money on the ads to
Right.
learn how it is actually, how it works or how it doesn't. So that time what I decided, I thought to join a job somewhere as a basic. And then this way I just started. So luckily I went out. This was very first time and I was quite nervous and I was carrying my iPad all with my resume and
Okay.
it was all, it was looking very classy. Honestly, I was not sure like what is going to happen on that day when I went for a job interview. It was very first day after my HR job. Then I went there and I cracked my interview. That was first. And HR took like 3 rounds of digital marketing interviews. The questions were some of the basic and then some of the technical, tactical questions were there. So I don't know what was it, but I just cracked it and I grabbed that job. And from that way, I learned digital marketing. You know what I used to do? I used to go in the morning time, in the daytime there, in my job, office hours, and I used to come back to my home and in late evening. So just I still remember that I used to ask to Gaurav like how this campaign would run and all. So Gaurav taught me like the campaign stuff and then other things also, he helped me a lot to do. But the great, the good thing was I got a budget, like 30,000 on Facebook ads and 50,000 on Google AdWords. So
Okay.
this was the way I started my digital marketing learning in this way. and the practical knowledge. So what I would suggest to the people, definitely they should go for the learnings, basics first. And without practical, without spending money on the advertisement, they can't learn till they have practical knowledge. They should go for the intern initially in any company if they are involving freshers in any campaign or marketing stuff. If they are involving those freshers, so it is going to help them a lot. They should not first go for a money, because money they definitely can earn later once they learn about the skill set, about the campaigns, about the budget and everything. When once they learn, then they can earn the money. Initially they should not expect if they can earn money or not. This was my way how to learn industrial marketing and enter into. Maybe this could help them if they implement this stuff. Maybe.
Right. Exactly. So first learn, then earn. There is a quote of like, first learn, then remove the L.
I have a lot of questions. People, there are a lot of questions that keep on coming. Like people, they ask me, Roshni, we have done a lot of, institute courses and all, but still we are not able to find the job. Because when I ask them, like, what exactly your expectation on them? So, expectation was, we want to earn 30,000, we want to earn 40,000 initially. My reaction was, like, first learn, because you just learn the basics from, whichever university or maybe institute you have learned. So this is all like basics you have learned so far. Till you don't have practical knowledge, company, they don't consider you as a, just like a ideal candidate for the company. They won't let you to run ads. They won't give you any budget. So you can't learn. So first go for the learning purpose first.
Yes, exactly. Like passing from the any institute, or it's like more like passing from the kindergarten nowadays.
Yeah, that's very true.
Yeah, but it comes to the point, like, even if you learn the digital marketing, the most of the things are getting automated, right? But what nowadays matters is more of a storytelling, or the narration is important, I guess. What your take on that? Like, I believe is the narration or the storytelling is important part if you're going into marketing. So what's your take on this in the last 4 years?
Marketing is all about storytelling, to be honest. It has nothing to do with when you talk about copywriting, creative, color combination, running an ad campaign or using social media platform. Whatever you talk, in any platform you talk about, it is all about storytelling. Because see, I remember that I was having a discussion about, or maybe I was talking to someone, one of my students. So I was telling him that there are two different worlds, right? One is the world where we are, living, right? If I talk about in terms of the product, whatever you are selling or whatever service or offer you have, definitely if you want to do something on digital marketing, so you are selling something, maybe any offer or product or your service, right? So anything, whatever you already have, that you want to sell that product, right? Now, we live in two different worlds. One is already there, and the other one is we want to build that world. Now, digital marketing is the way where we connect from the existing world to our imaginary world. So it would happen on the basis of story only. And story, we narrate that entire story about our service, about our product, or any concept, whatever we do, that all together we convey that in a story format on entire digital world, so that whatever we are selling, that should go to the right audience. So storytelling is a great, great way to convince your audience and to convey your message to the right audience. So basically you are building a brand, and brand cannot be completed without a storytelling. And once you are clear about the storytelling part, then you would be able to talk about the copywriting stuff, so whatever you do. So first story comes, and then later it comes to copywriting. Then it's landing page or maybe autoresponder, whatever we talk about. So it is a later process. So first you need to think about the what is the story, what is the hook. So that's you can say that the big thing. Without this, it is not possible.
Yes, like based on the previous question, I would like to ask like how you started with storytelling. Because see, whoever enters the digital marketing or this stuff, he's not the he's not the pro at the storytelling, or he's like not already read something, or he's not have that skills at the starting period. So how you develop the storytelling skills? Like obviously the product changes every time, like at every damn time product changes. So how you build a story about that product, or how you get through this?
See, people need to understand it, because there, if I talk about, everybody knows about digital marketing, considering that one. There are some pros, pro experts, which we call experts, and there are some people who just run, just make creative and do some basic copywriting, and then they run ads and they get some clicks and then some conversions as well, right? So it happens this way. So people think this is the digital marketing. And this happens. But actually what happens is somebody is starting. So I can completely understand it, because no one is pro if he's starting. So he has no knowledge of what he is starting, right? And about the storytelling, he doesn't know. He's not aware of it. So they need to understand it. People, the one thing is here, the one core concept, which they need to understand it whenever they are starting. So people don't buy product. People buy emotion. People buy relationship. That's how we work on digital marketing. So once they are clear about it, what type of emotions they can sell, then they would be able to understand it, what type of storytelling it would work, what type of copywriting it would work. So they have to understand it from their own mind. So they are not selling a product. They are selling emotions. Once they are clear about it, emotions, then they would be able to do the copywriting part easily. That's how I learned, because I was also not, initially when I started, I also used to do the same mistake. Whenever I'm writing something, okay, this is the product, this is the headline, this is the features, and this is the call to action, this is the creative, this is the graphic, and redirecting to that user to the landing page, and all done. That's all. It never happens that way. So we have to craft a journey from starting to the end. And we have to take care of that journey from what we are selling to the end point. So basically it's a customer journey, and that customer journey has to be in a storytelling way. So they have to think about what is the storytelling first of all, whenever they are starting. So in this, what they can do, they can see some of the big brands, examples. They should study about the branding strategies like Apple or HP or maybe water bottle or maybe any big brands, how they do it. For example, if I give you one of the great examples, which I personally like this, which is the Airtel. So you can now see the difference. Earlier, wherever the Air, Jio or maybe Airtel, those brands, they used to do the branding stuff. So it was not connecting, because there was some endorsement of with the actors, right? The celebrities. Yes. So everybody knows about the celebrities, whatever they are selling or not. But nowadays, if you notice that there is, with the Airtel, there is one girl who is talking about emotions. And there is no when you see that girl, it is without makeup, just like a very normal person, so that they can relate to the very ordinary person. And there is no model, nothing. It was all like ordinary girl and speaking about the experiences, right? Yes. So have you seen that advertisement, that Airtel, that girl comes and she speaks about her experiences and all?
Obviously, after the Jio, like everyone is marketing their own strategy. So obviously, everyone sees that.
Yes. So you can say that now they are not selling the service directly. They are actually selling the emotions. That's a great example. Everybody can see that. If you notice that one, the people are selling emotions. And people are also giving this one, okay, just go out and try everything else, then come to us. We talk about the quality here. So it is not, they are not giving the direct things. Okay, we are selling this one, so just go and get this out. No, they are not doing this one. They are selling, they are even not talking about the product there. They are talking about the emotions. It is a like a common problem what we are facing, and they are focusing on that problem only, and they are selling through the emotions.
Yes, exactly. So like you already mentioned all about the emotions. So how much human psychology involved in the digital marketing? Because I have read an article on the medical business, like they tends to about the whenever they come across an ad, like the human psychology involved in it. Like how you come across, have you come across it, or what is your take?
Sorry, I did not get your question.
Okay, so you already talk about the emotions, right?
Right, right.
There is an article I read which talk about the human psychology. Like the great marketers, they try to target the human psychology. So that's when they get the sales or the whatever they want to sell. So like, have you come across it or have you tried it? What's your take?
I always do that one. I never try without psychology, not a single ad. I always try to be, I don't go with the broad one. I always would go with the specific one. And those specific would be always the psychology based only. I won't target everybody. I would target on the psychology base. That would be very narrow. Okay. So it is a great, here it's a thing that you have to understand. It. Psychology does matter a lot in DM, in digital marketing.
Okay. So like I got a one, I posted a poll and I got a one question on Instagram. Like if a company is starting from the scratch, so to make a good sale, let's say around 100 products or 100 sales, how much it will time take the audience to convert that sales, like audience into sales?
You know what, this is the question. I'll tell you, you know, I want to like share a quick thing here.
Sure.
It is someone is starting up affiliate marketing, right?
Okay.
And before starting that one, so there were like few other questions. Roshni, just tell us like how much we can earn, okay? And what would be the exact amount we need for investment? And what would be the exact amount we can earn? So do you have any guarantee we can earn that much money? So people, they don't understand it. Don't expect that thing at the moment. You can do the cost cutting and all, but nobody can tell you how exactly, like 100 products, how, I'm not a, you know, just like a, so I cannot do the forecasting, right? It all happens with the, you're in, what do we call that? I'm just forgetting the name.
Journey of the ads.
So optimizing the stuff, and you know, you just have to see the what type of product it works in market, and what is the take on like what type of audience they are doing, like liking your product or not. It totally depends. Keep on testing things. So nobody can tell you how much time it will take. If somebody says that one, so I'm not sure how on what basis they are telling, but it never happens this way. Nobody can tell you actually how much time it would take. But yes, definitely you have to give at least 3 to 6 months if you are starting something. So after 6 months, you would probably know like, oh, you are getting results or not. On the basis of that, you can do the calculation part. But initially 6 months, you cannot say anything.
So I guess that, hope people will take that and they will start on their own.
Starting is a good one. Definitely, if someone is starting, I do understand it. If I am also putting my money and the investment part is there, so probably there will a lot of things in my mind would be there, like, okay, I'm putting this amount now in my business. What would happen next? What would happen after 1 month? What would happen after 2 months? I do understand it. But you know the calculation part, how it should be. It should be like your product, one product cost is this. And if you sell in a month this, and your ROI would be this, and then the annual ROI would be this. So this is just like a random idea you calculate about your profits, right?
Right.
But for that one, you have to understand the marketing strategy first. Like if that product is going audience they are liking or not, if that the reviews are coming good or not, if the landing page is good or not, the strategies which you follow is good or not, your target audience is right or not. There are a lot of things which would happen between in like 6 months of testing.
Yes, exactly. So the next question comes is, which field do you prefer, LinkedIn or Instagram?
It totally depends on the product. For example, if I want to go with the project, so definitely LinkedIn would be the first choice. But if I have a anything, for example, like short course or maybe low product price, like under 1,000 or 1,000 rupees, or maybe under 1,500 or 2,000 rupees, so I would definitely target on Instagram as well. But if I talk about the high-paying clients or project or company, so LinkedIn is my first choice always. Because I have got like 18 projects with the LinkedIn itself. I never paid single penny. And I have got a lot of speaking opportunities to the single platform, LinkedIn only. So LinkedIn is my favorite platform, and it will be always. But yes, I do marketing in all social media platforms. Obviously, as being a marketer, you have to do it. But LinkedIn would be my first preference for everything.
Yes, exactly. I saw you were a course about the LinkedIn. What is that course about, and what is? Can you brief about your course?
Actually, I am teaching people about all my 3 years of experience with the LinkedIn, like how I have got all the speaking opportunities, and how I have got all the projects, and how I have got the job. So basically, in marketing, in LinkedIn marketing, I'm teaching people how they can start from basic to an advanced level, where I am covering a lot of things. For example, like how to getting sales and leads, and how to get dream jobs and all. If they want to switch their job, they can do with the job prospect, or maybe if they are the freelancer, if they they want to have some projects, how they can target and find projects as well. So this is all. And this would be, I'm covering entire from starting with beginner to an advanced level, where I am teaching people organic and paid marketing, both on LinkedIn. So basically, this course is for everybody, students, entrepreneurs, business owners, or anybody who's having an online business or online existence. So I'm teaching this course is perfect for them. If their audience is on LinkedIn. If not, obviously LinkedIn is not for them.
Okay, so specifically you're targeting the whoever have the LinkedIn audience, right?
Mm-hmm. No. I'm not targeting only who's having a LinkedIn audience. It's not like that. I'm targeting people who's having business. For example, okay, I'll tell you what it's like in a brief way. So LinkedIn is, for example, if I talk about the style or maybe you are selling a top or jeans, or if you are in clothing industry, right, e-com basically, so if you're selling those, so LinkedIn is not for them, right, because you can sell your top jeans or whatever you are selling, so you can do that marketing on Instagram, Facebook. Right. It is the best for them. But if I talk about you are selling high-paying, course, for example, I want to sell the course, and my target audience is company's owners or maybe some sales managers or maybe HR managers or some of the employees. For example, if you have a CRM software and you want to sell that software, so who would be your target audience? Obviously, you are not going to target Facebook or Instagram for that, right? Because obviously there are no employees, no professionals. I mean, this is good for social networking, but professionals, if you want to sell your CRM software or maybe course, so obviously LinkedIn would be the best platform, right? Because here, you can directly reach out to the HR, and through the HR, you can reach out to the other people and employees directly, right? But you cannot do the same way on Facebook or Instagram or any other social media platform. So if you talk about the professional terms, obviously LinkedIn would be the best platform for that.
Okay. So as you already talked about your course, like I want to ask you, what is your favorite thing in the marketing?
What is my favorite thing in marketing?
Yeah.
That's the storytelling. That's a storytelling. I cannot survive without storytelling. So you know what happens? I'll tell you what exactly happens. If I go downstairs or I travel anywhere, like if I'm in the airplane or maybe in the train or wherever I'm traveling, if I'm having an egg on, you know, ready wala, you can say that, I always, there is something going on inside my mind. It keeps on running something. Okay, this can be my story. Okay, that can be my story. That would be my story. This would be my story. So it just happens. This happens when you keep on thinking about the marketing stuff. So you never know how and in what way it comes and it's stuck your mind. Okay, this is the story. So I really live in the world of storytelling and I really love this one. And I always keep on testing as well. I get results, I get more excited than I try with the more stories and the marketing stuff. So yes, storytelling is the best part in marketing.
Yeah, actually, even I'm going to tell you that the storytelling, even I believe, is the best because I read also the medical books also. So there is a book, they mentioned that why children's, we should tell the stories to the children's. Actually, they develop their belief system. Like whatever the fairy tale or whatever we tell to the students, so they develop a belief system so they can trust the anyone.
Right.
Okay, that's the, I mean, the basic of the, we can say is the basic of the storytelling, because when we were a child, there is a belief developed in our mind. That's why
right.
The online world works right. So
very true.
Coming to the some of the serious questions, how do you see the future of the digital marketing?
How do I see future of digital marketing? I wish I could 100% accurate on this question, but I see a bright future for the digital marketing. It is not going down. I don't see people, they feel or they might face any kind of issue with the digital marketing, because everything is now digital. And now we in village also, people, they are using smartphones and they are using laptops. So one way or other way, they are somewhere, they are related to coming on digital space. So if you talk about in India, still there are a lot of villages which is yet to be covered with the digital space. But yes, definitely in coming future, they are going to cover with the digital space itself. So I don't find anything downfall in digital space. It is going to be huge and bright.
Yes, But there is a world question also about the audience. Like, audience is also getting the smartest. Like, everyone can understand this is an ad or this is something. This is a part of the digital marketing. So, what do you think about it? Like, the audience is also getting.
So that's smarter. Okay. If audience are getting, they are getting smarter. So we are also getting smarter. That's okay. Say, if I give you an example, there are doctors, right, and there are patients as well.
Yes.
So it never happens like there are a lot of doctors, so there are no patients. So obviously, if people are getting smarter, so marketers are also getting smarter. So it keeps on changing, right? The trends come and we have to follow the trend. So we have to improve ourselves as well in terms of marketing. So if the one trend is coming, the other one, we are also improving our strategies. So it will, you know, going to happen continuously. So trend will come, we'll follow the trend. So we always will be one step ahead before the trend comes.
Okay.
So
we have to.
This is how we will. Sorry?
We have to take one step ahead.
Yeah, exactly. We have to. That's why we are marketers. And there's a difference between marketer and a smart marketer. So one of the smart marketers always would be one step ahead. So if he would understand what kind of audience they have, obviously they have to be one step ahead.
Yes. Like coming to the
who would not love to have a smart audience? Obviously, you are not going to keep donkeys, right? And it's just like not often. It's just like obviously you need smart people, and this will be a great. Actually, they are solving. If people are smart enough to understand it, actually they are solving our problem, all the marketers' problem, because it's now earlier you have to educate them from the basic, from the scratch. But now you have to tell people from at least they know, right? So it is a great, what we can, you know, advantage for us that people are getting smarter. So now they are making a way so that we can even teach them more.
Yes, and we can minimum the budget.
Yeah, minimum the budget, right?
Yes. So any three tips you want to give who want to start in the digital marketing on the specific social media or complete digital marketing stuff? Because see, digital marketing is a whole umbrella, and you cannot just like, we have to go for the any specific concept, like either the social media marketing or the SEO part. So what do you think that where should student go?
I think I never done SEO part. So they should go with the social media marketing first and Google AdWords, because the ratio is what I felt it is going to help them if they are starting with the social. As you said, like digital marketing, it's a like whole umbrella. So obviously nobody can do the expertise in everything, right?
Right.
So they have to start with something. So if you ask me what should they start, so I always, my vote always would be for the social media marketing and AdWords or YouTube. So this, either they go for the AdWords. AdWords still it is a bit difficult to start with, but social media marketing they always can start. Because in social media marketing, they would cover all the social media platforms. So it would be easy for them to getting a job or maybe getting projects. It would be easy for them. And later, once they have done with the social media marketing, they can go with the Google AdWords or maybe Bing AdWords, Gmail Ads, whatever they want to start. And under AdWords, they can go with it. But they should start with the social media marketing.
Like, this is my personal question, that how much do you see the email marketing works in the India or the SMS marketing works in the India? Have you tried it, or what's your result about the email marketing and SMS marketing? Because I've seen when I did something on email marketing.
Okay, you tell me one thing, if you talk about email marketing here, so are you talking about the data? I mean, like, 2 crores, 3 crores of data when they buy data and then they do the email marketing part. You're talking about that data, or you maybe own subscribers?
No, obviously, I want the subscribers. Obviously, that data doesn't work,
even I know. It is a self-explanatory that email marketing, SMS marketing, obviously, it has a great scope. I do it every day. I do affiliate marketing through the email marketing only. So I have been doing email marketing, like when I entered into this industry. So it's every day I have the goal, like I have to end my day with this, my goal is like this much of amount. It has to be every day. So that's how I work. I mean, I work for the company and like my own company, obviously. So there is a like goal, and this goal has to finish with this one. So I do it. My email marketing is a separate one. My training is a different one. The marketing stuff is different one. So I do a lot of stuff. So what I see, email marketing and SMS marketing has a great scope. But it has to be your own subscribers only.
Yes, obviously. Yeah.
No, it is a serious one, because I saw like some of the people, I got like few of the questions, and they say, Roshni, we have got the data, and now you please guide us how we can do the email stuff. I said, okay, how you got the data? They said, no, this is our own data. I said, yeah. I asked them, like, what type of data, how you have got it? Obviously, see, if I am guiding something, I need to have the details. That exactly. After that only I can guide, right? So they said, no, we have purchased the data from this, 5 lakhs of data from, some of the source, I don't remember. I said, no, I'm not going to have this one. Because obviously it is not going to give you a result. You are doing here spamming. It is not your own subscribers. So obviously it is not going to give you any result.
Right. So like that's where the storytelling parts come.
Yeah, exactly.
So I also have the digital marketing strength also. But there is a, I cannot say contradiction, but there are some beliefs who takes only one page, if you create a sales page, to go for the only one page and someone goes...
Ronald, can you please speak a bit louder? Sorry, I just lost your voice.
I do have a digital marketing friends. There are two types of people. One who go for the only one page, like if you created a sales page or sales funnel also. There are some who go for the only one page, and there are one who goes with the 3-4 stages, like... If we click on the ad, then there will go for the 3-4 pages, and after that they will see something. So what will
you're talking about the upgrades, right?
not exactly updates. If we click on the add something or if we created a sales funnel, so there are someone who goes with the only one stage and someone who goes with the 3 to 4 stages. Like I personally go with the 3 to 4 stages. The bad quality people or the bad audience get filtered. So what do you think on this? Like, is it a good way of doing it or going for the only one stage is a very good way?
No, there should not be only one stage. There should be at least 2 stages. Because if you really think about the quality leads, so it has to be 2-1. So, because see, like when we scrolling our social media platform, so there are like campaigns, which is a lead gen campaigns, right? So when we click that, so automatically it fills up. So obviously we are not aware of it, like what where we are giving our details and people are taking our details, right? They are not aware of it. Instead of doing that one, you should educate first and we should take permission that we are taking your email address or your details for this product or maybe this way. And they have to, in the second stage, they have to activate their email ID while coming into whatever it goes to their email address. They have to confirm that email ID and then you are good to go, right? So at least there should be 2 steps, not one. One, it doesn't give that much value. Even I don't do one step. I always do the 2-step verification or 2 stages.
Okay. Yeah. So I guess there is enough of value available in this podcast episode because we have almost covered from the basics to the almost high-level question also. But to the end, what
was it high-level question?
I guess for the... for one who is doing the digital marketing,
who is starting, right?
Yeah, for them, right. Obviously they have to first learn everything. they will understand everything, right?
There is the one thing which I have realized: people, the first thing they have to learn that how to be a patient enough, and they should not worry about the result. They should first learn, and now these days people, they don't have patience. They always think they are, learning from the institute and they expect to get a job, 50,000, 1 lakh rupees or project. And then they lose momentum in the between and then they, start putting allegations on that this marketing is not good way, it is not giving me good results, I'm not getting clients. So people are not patient enough. They should learn how to have patience for to learn this marketing.
Exactly. Everyone wants the quick bucks right now.
Yeah, people, they ask me about LinkedIn also. So when they say, Roshni, we want results. I said, okay, just go and just try and just get some results. Do it your own self then. And see, it took me three and a half years to get all this stuff, right? I got featured on LinkedIn. So I became top voice of India on LinkedIn. So it took me 3.5 years. It did not happen, 1 month, 2 months, or year. It took me 3.5 years. So obviously, now it is giving me value, and now it is giving me benefits. So they have to understand it. It never happens in just overnight.
Yes, exactly. Even the if you follow Gary Vee, he also says the same thing. Like, people have to be patient.
That's very true. earlier when I was starting, I can relate this one because I know I was also one of them. I was like, no, I'm not getting results. I'm not. However, I was lucky enough. I don't know how my luck did work with me on this. I got the job. Then I got, there was like a 99.9% wherever I went for the project, I cracked that project. I don't know how, but yeah, I was like confident enough to handle that project and I got the project. So I used to think that I'm not getting results, or maybe it's just like I run a campaign for 1 week or 10 days, 15 days. I used to think this campaign is not working because that time I did not aware of the storytelling part when I was starting my career. Like if I talk about starting with the 6 months or 1 year, I was not aware of the storytelling part. Obviously, who would care even, right? Because I know how to run campaign, how to put the ad budget and all. So I know that I'm a marketer, I can do it, all the stuff. But as I grew up and with this marketing stuff, the psychology behind that, then I know, okay, this is the only thing in marketing which actually can grab the attention and where you actually you can become a celebrity, you can say that in the DM. So now I know what works, what doesn't work.
Exactly. It counts to all 3 years of experience.
Yeah, very true.
Yeah. So before I end, what's your motto in life? Like you are also teaching students also. So what's your motto behind the teaching stuff and what you want to do in future?
See, I want to have 2,000 employees, not really employees. I want to have a 2,000, you know, working shoulders with me so that they can work with me. Initially, I'll go, my target is initial 200, then I'll go with the 2,000, then 20,000. So basically, I want to have a large team. They should work with me. So I really want to work as a leader, not as a boss. And I really want a lot of hands along with me. They should work. So you can say that I really see a big company with like 2,000 members, family members, you can say that. Because you know why I am thinking this way? Because I used to work alone when I was starting. When I started my career in DM, so I used to work alone. It was like pathetic feeling when I used to work alone. I used to cry sometimes, like I was working with the project and all. It was pathetic feeling. So from that day, I decided to at least I'll go and help people and I'll create job opportunities for more people and they should work with me, not under me. It can be in the office, it can be from home or wherever. So I'm really putting my hard efforts to create job opportunities for people. This is the one of the motto. And the second motto is, I have already trained in directly or indirectly 10,000 of folks already, and I want to train more 50,000 people as soon as possible. So I'm just targeting in 2020. If I can do that one, so obviously that would be my second motto. Let's see how it goes.
Yes, actually you deserve what you desire. So I am damn sure that you will achieve your target.
Yeah, I keep on dreaming. I live my dream every day. I know it is not true, but definitely I have a strong belief that definitely one day it will happen. So what I do, I live my dream every day. I see that dream, I live that dream. When you go to my page on my personal website, you can see that what is my expectation, what my desire and what is my goal. So that's how I written there in a small part that I live my dream every day.
Yeah, I will put the link of your Instagram, LinkedIn and your course also. So the audience can check it and definitely enroll for your course also. So
that would be great. Okay, you are helping me to achieve my target sooner.
actually, it's a win-win situation, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, see, I am charging like... 777 only, that's like 777. It's I kept this very pocket friendly so that I can train many people. If I'm you know, I want to train a lot of people, that has no number, no limitation. Otherwise, if I talk about the profile optimization, I used to charge like $1,000 or $1,500 for the profile optimizations only. I used to do the handle part of the LinkedIn.
Okay.
But now I'm not doing it. I really want to train people so that they get good the results and they learn about more about digital marketing stuff.
Yes, exactly. Because these institutes, like, they are just like, we can say that illusion because they charge very high, but they just talk about the basic part, I guess. Even because I also started with the self-education because I started in my second year of my college. I mean, last year I graduated, but I still do the marketing stuff. So that's why I know many of these like parameters. So I also,
sometimes I always think that, why we have even went to college for our graduation or post-graduation. So, you know, there is nothing in relation between mathematics, what we have learned in integration and differentiation in our earlier days. I don't find the link what we learn in our college or school, and there is nothing in our regular life, in our digital marketing.
Right, exactly. Because you don't believe I did mechanical engineering. And I'm doing stuff in the marketing. So like it's almost a different sector.
Right. Yeah, it must have been interesting field for you. That's why you just, you know, came into this industry, maybe.
Exactly, just like you, maybe luck.
Yeah. Do you like laptop lifestyle? I mean, carrying your laptop and going and traveling and then earning from anywhere.
Exactly. That's why I do also freelancing also. So obviously I do that stuff.
You know what happens? I'm not sure if, is it too long or like what? We can still talk.
Yeah, we can still talk. It's hardly 40 minutes.
Okay.
So if you want to share an example or something, then you can.
I mean, if you see now these days on social media platforms, when we see a lot of feed, which we, some of the people, they don't trust. I understand it because there are online scams and all. So when we share something, we are traveling, we are earning money from anywhere. See, we are doing that one, we are doing this one. So a lot of people, they think this is a dream. This never happens. It is like people are just showing off. So I don't know how to tell them this is actually not a dream. This is actually true. And people are doing it. People are making a lot of money. And people are traveling. People are actually making money from anywhere. They are actually living the lifestyle. And this is the one thing which you literally can do with the digital marketing itself.
Yes, but so, you need patience for that, I guess, almost at least.
Yeah, they have to trust, first of all. They have to start believing in this happens. This is the thing. It is not a dream.
It can happen with anyone.
Yeah, it can happen with anyone. Yeah, I can do it. Anybody can do it, what I feel like.
Exactly. So, but there is also point where, like, if you have come across, like, many of the whoever come across this, like, whoever try to teach or this type of stuff, courses and all, they are also doing like a clickbait also, like to get the maximum output. But when we enroll into their course, it feels like there is nothing in it. So it is also come across like trust building that you already told about it.
This should not happen. I know there are a lot of people doing it because there should be a good motive. There should be a good intention. If you really want to help people, you should educate people first. And then you have to be more careful about the other people's success, right? So I don't know like about others, what they're doing. I never, because a lot of people, they think I've learned from, what's the name? I'm forgetting the name. Anyways, I should not take name anywhere.
That's what I'm doing.
Yeah, right. Well, that's okay. But still, people are smart now. Audience, as you said earlier, people are getting smarter now. So I know they know like where to invest and where to not. So what I personally feel, everybody has to believe someone, and there is necessary of mentorship. So they should always select one mentor, and they should follow that whatever mentor says. The strategies, the concepts, whatever he says or she says, they should go with that one. So my mentor is necessary for anybody. I have got my mentor. God has taught me a lot of things. And I also, you know, whenever I feel stuck somewhere or whenever I feel like this is not working, that is not working, or I got somewhere, I always go to Gaurav and ask him like how I can do this one. And he always helps me. And now Gaurav and me both are like co-founders for the same company. We work in the same company. So it was lucky for me, I got my mentor. So what I should suggest, everybody, they should have mentors in their life. And they should believe that mentor and they should follow the strategies, whatever the mentor says.
Exactly. Actually, this is what I realized the last year when after graduation, actually, that I need a mentor. So I was searching for it and I got one because before that, I used to like do everything, every opportunity. But I realized that, okay, you cannot take that every bite you want to take. You have to fix it and you have to do it for that only. Like I you said correctly, like mentor is like one of the important thing in life. Otherwise, it's like
right.
It's like a directionless.
Very true. Very true.
Yeah.
Because as you said, without mentor, you would be doing anything. Because if you have noticed any time when you come online and when you search on something on Google, so there are like 30-40 tabs, and you end up with doing nothing. This happens with everybody, I guess. This used to happen with me as well, like few months back. You know, I just wanted to start something, and then I started, and I started with something, then I ended up like with 30 tabs. And I used to think what exactly I have done in the entire day, non-productive. So definitely you should have a mentor and you should have a guidance what you're doing. So you have to be focused enough with the one thing, and you should excel that one, and then you should go with the other thing. And this can be done with the help of mentor only, because he would only or she would only tell you what exactly you have to do. You know just how what we call in Hindi, ghode ki naal, it's just like one direction.
Yes.
So mentor is just like that.
Right, right. So like before we end our conversation, can you tell us the biggest ups and downs in your life? As you already talk about the many things, so one of the biggest ups and one of the biggest downs in your life?
Emotional balance, mental balance, that's the biggest ups and downs in anybody's life, in my life also. Because I kept myself busy with the work stuff, and I was like so much involved with my work, my training, and then because I do multiple things. So I really, because I like it, that's the reason I do it. So as being an entrepreneur, there are a lot of things up and down in your mind and your mental and your emotional balance. Sometimes you feel lonely because you know that now if you talk about as being an entrepreneur, you don't have, when you go talk to your friends, so probably they would not understand it, what is exactly you're going through. So you would not be able to make them understand what exactly you think, right? Because it's a like very difficult situation in anybody's life. Anybody's is not like entrepreneurs, business owners.
Exactly.
So if you have not noticed something, like big people or entrepreneurs, business owners, whoever they are working, they are all they work alone. However, if you see from outside, you feel like they are, you know, working with a team, a big family, big thing. But it's not like that. The real thing is they work alone. The emotional and mental balance is just like the biggest challenge you have to control over it. And I spoke a lot of friends, and I spoke one of the, I cannot actually take name here, but I was speaking to them as well. So they also have the same thing as the feeling that I feel, anybody's life. So mental and emotional balance, you have to control. You have to take control over it. So this is the biggest thing. Money would come, definitely money would come. If you keep on working, so money would flow in. But yeah, you have to take care about it. You have to take a control of your emotional and your mental balance.
Okay, maybe that's the gem of the podcast, that emotional balance is the one of the important thing in anybody's life.
Yeah, very true.
Yeah. So thank you so much, Roshni, for taking time to be on this podcast and giving the valuable information to everyone. I guess, hope you also enjoyed it.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. It's my pleasure, honor to have you and calling me for this podcast. I really enjoyed a lot. Thank you very much for having me on this podcast.